Whether you have played Viewfinder or not, the concept of a puzzle game where you can capture a section of the world and place it wherever you need is both intriguing and innovative. This idea captured my imagination, and here is my attempt to bring it to life in Unity. Polygon 3D models consist of faces, edges, and vertices. When slicing them in real time, it's crucial to consider the complexity and poly count of the geometry. Cutting intricate models demands significant computational power, which can lead to serious performance issues. This was one of the first things I noticed while playing the game. The level geometries are simple, composed of basic shapes to avoid such problems. To cut a model, we can use the Plane class along with some calculations. First, we define a plane, an infinite flat surface that represents the cutting position, splitting the 3D space into two sides. Next, we determine which vertices of the geometry fall on each side and generate two separate meshes. During this process, we encounter triangles that have vertices on both sides. These triangles are key in determining the new vertices needed to create fresh triangles, filling the gaps created by the cut. Next, we need a method to determine what to slice and what to preserve. It's clear that slicing affects everything within the camera's view borders. So we use the camera's frustum shape to create colliders that can scan the environment through the collision system. To detect objects at the edges, we will generate 14 parallelepipeds. And for everything within the view, we will use a large trapezoid to cover the entire frustum. These thin colliders also define the cutting position, so we use their transform to generate slicing planes, following the logic we previously established. With that, we have built the core of the system. Before continuing with the game mechanics, let's first create our environment and level. Using Blender, we can model simple objects that mimic the game's original aesthetic. The puzzle is shaped by how we position walls, floors, and other elements, blending in some of the logic pattern from the original game. We will take a look at the final result at the end. Let's also create the levels and portal and the camera model. Background elements play a crucial role. At first glance, they might look like a part of a standard HDRI or something mapped onto a sphere with reversed normals. But that's not the case. The objects are real, and you can appreciate the parallax effect as you move around. This is important because you will want to be able to cut them. In Viewfinder, you expect to slice through everything in the frame, and that's one of the most satisfying parts of the game. P.S. Some elements in the game, like the cat, can be cut or copied. You can replicate this by applying layer filtering to specific objects. The developers meticulously designed every detail of the world to emphasize the slicing mechanic. For instance, what appears to be fog below the horizon is actually a large object with a graded material simulating a fog effect. Additionally, all the scene's lighting is baked into the model's textures. If we relied on real-time lighting, objects spawned from the picture wouldn't match the original shading, since they would interact with light differently. By baking lights and shadows into the textures in Blender, and using unlit materials, we create a consistent, unchanging environment. For educational purposes, we will use HDRP fog below the horizon to demonstrate the limitation it brings to this type of scenario. Our player character uses a basic character controller that can move, jump, and rotate. The camera model is parented to the player so it can be carried around. The camera and picture states are controlled by an animator controller, requiring animations like look in and look out, as well as a shaking animation for when the player is walking or idling. To create a second point of view, or the model's camera eye, we need a secondary Unity camera set to render onto a square ratio texture. The key is to disable the second camera at the moment the shot is taken. so the render texture freezes, capturing a specific moment in time, just like a real photograph. Having a second Unity camera unlocks creative possibilities. For example, you can use it to display objects that are only visible through the camera lens by filtering with culling masks, or apply different post-processing effects to each camera. Now, it's time to integrate the player's input with the cutting mechanic. Let's start with the shooting mechanic. When a picture is taken, we apply our logic to cut the environment, preserving what's within the frustum and hiding what's outside. Before performing the cut, we duplicate the game objects so that they appear untouched. The cut objects are then parented to a transform representing the camera's point of view, allowing them to move and rotate with the player. You have probably guessed the next step. To reintegrate the frame view into the world, we cut the environment, the little objects inside the frustum, and re-enable the previously cut objects. And that's the trick. Just like in the game, we will also add a button to rotate the picture and the hidden objects, which will open many new puzzle possibilities. As you can imagine, a lot of computation occurs during these frames, which is why it's essential to keep the scene-like weight and design everything around the core feature. Of course, this is just a case study. The team behind the game has likely optimized the process significantly or approached the mechanic differently. Do you have any other ideas on how to achieve this? Let me know in the comments. Also, for more insights into the cutting process and idea, I recommend checking out this video from Christine League. Before we reveal the final result, we want to remind you that this is Unity Unite Week. We will be attending the event in Barcelona as Unity Insiders, and look forward to connecting with you and exploring Unity's future together. Now, here is the final result and gameplay. Please help our channel reach a wider audience by subscribing. It's a small action for you, but a huge boost for us. Let us know if you enjoyed the project and what you would like to see next. Cheers!